assessment of the medical patient skill station. This station is another one of the stations where you really need to follow a methodical top-to-bottom process in your assessment approach. You want to remember two things here: a good sample history and OPQRST, onset, provokes, quality, radiates, severity, and time when assessing any painful sign or symptom, as well as finding out what interventions the patient used to treat that prior to your arrival. So let's jump on in to the process for the patient assessment of a medical patient skill station. Start off with scene safety, BSI. You need to verbalize or take body substance isolation and determine if the scene is safe. You want to determine the mechanism of injury or nature of illness and determine the number of patients you have, followed by the request for additional help if you think you're going to need it. This may include requesting ALS assistance in patients that may need ALS intervention. You're also going to consider whether you need to stabilize C-spine. This is part of your normal scene size up. You'll then move into the initial assessment. You want to verbalize your general impression of the patient. Ask the preceptor, what do they look like? Determine responsiveness and level of consciousness. Determine what the chief complaint is, and also look for any apparent life threats. Assess airway and breathing. Assess whether they have any major bleeding, and assess for pulse and skin color, temperature, and condition. You now want to identify priority of patient and make a transport decision. Are you going to stay and play, or do you need to load and go? You'll now follow up with a focused history and a physical exam, perhaps a rapid assessment in a more critical patient. Remember that some patients will have certain aspects of their assessment that are different when compared to others, depending on the chief complaint determined above. But all patients will have the following steps assessed. You will start out by assessing any signs or symptoms, assessing the history of the present illness. You will include an OPQRST assessment of the patient's pain and any sudden onset items like shortness of breath. You will move on and assess for allergies, find out the patient's medications, ask about any past pertinent medical history, when they had last oral intake, and events leading up to the present illness, ruling out trauma. You will perform a focused physical examination of the patient, assessing the affected body part or system, or perhaps complete a rapid assessment of the patient. You will obtain baseline vital signs and move on to performing any interventions that may be necessary. This will include properly obtaining medical direction or verbalizing that a medication is a standing order med, and you will verbalize proper additional intervention and treatment. This may include proper administration of the medication as necessary. After completing your focused history and physical assessment or rapid assessment, as well as any indicated interventions, you'll want to reevaluate your transport decision and decide to initiate transport sooner as necessary. You'll also want to verbalize that you are considering completing a complete head-to-toe detailed physical exam as well. You will then verbalize that you are going to continue ongoing assessment during transport, including repeating your initial assessment, repeat vital signs, and repeating your focused assessment regarding patient complaint or injuries. You also want to state exactly how often you would do this based on the priority of the patient. You are now finished the medical patient assessment. There are some critical criteria that you want to make sure you pay attention to while doing this assessment. If you failed to take scene safety or BSI precautions, If you did not obtain medical direction or verbalize your standing order for any medical interventions, if you failed at any point to provide appropriate high-flow O2 to the patient, if you did not find or manage problems associated with airway, breathing, hemorrhage, or shock, if you did not differentiate the patient's need for rapid transport versus continued assessment at the scene, if you did your detailed or focused history and physical exam before you completed your initial assessment, the airway, breathing, and circulation assessment, and if you did not ask questions about the present illness, and if you did any administration of a dangerous or completely inappropriate intervention, these would all be critical fail points.